all up.
That's a flag on the plate. Let's go.
Touchdown, I just scored a whole bucket. I just dropped a bag on the tag, ain't nothing. Make them throw a flag when I pass, come through stunning. Call me tired, girl, and hit the hole, then I'm running. Get money, let's go. You ain't trying to get that sack of flag on the plate. Hating from the sideline, a flag on the plate. Like Julio with them Falcons, I just made a play. In the red zone, going strong, watch me shake and bake.
Let's go.
I just took off with that rock, just like Tyreek Hill. I just count 100 racks, that's a whole field. He don't want no championship, get him out of here. I just got a sack, like I run up in the backfield. I just got a sack, like I ran up on a quarterback. Shake and bake, make a play just like a quarterback. We ain't worrying about no farmers, we ain't staying there. Running off the block, yeah, I'm something like a linebacker. I got juice like a Fanta, how you like it?
How you like it?
I'm on purple, I'm on yellow, like a Viking.
Like a Viking.
All these plays that I'm catching, I done gone crazy. I do my thing, six range, just like Tom Brady. Touchdown, I just scored a whole bucket. I just dropped a bag on the tag, ain't nothing. Make them throw a flag when I pass, come through stunning. Call me tired, girl, and hit the hole, then I'm running. Get money, you ain't trying to get that sack of flag on the play. Hating from the sideline, a flag on the play. Like Julio with them Falcons, I just made a play. In the red zone, going strong, watch me shake and bake.
Let's go.
I'm in the field like a Panther, I done up the standards. Like Michael Vick in Atlanta when it's time to scramble. Neck full of water, call me Black Bridgewater. Lamar Jackson, how I throw them Ravens cross the border.
Hold up. You know I'm a touchdown with the sack.
It's the NFL on EA Sports, coming to you now from the foot of the Rockies in Denver, Colorado. A moment ago, through a shower of pyrotechnics, it was the hometown Broncos taking the field as they get set to do battle with the Arizona Cardinals.
Kickoff for Arizona.
And off we go from Denver. And the mile high air in full effect as that's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. They'll run. This is Melvin Gordon. For just what you want on a first down run, call it 8 yards, and it's second and two.
A nice run here early on. It doesn't take a great play call to realize you want to establish a guy of his caliber with runs like this early, because it'll pay dividends as the game progresses.
Eight yards the gain on that last run. Here's second and a couple. Fakes the give to Gordon. Now here's Locke to throw. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete. That time he was looking for Jerry Jeudy, and it's third and short.
Third down and two.
From the gun, it's Locke. Got a man, it's Jeudy, complete. The 30, the 20.
You know they pay me extra.
And all the way home for a Broncos score. Jerry Jeudy. 67 yards, and the Broncos have taken the early lead. Well, that's how they envisioned it, get the football to start the game and score.
And I don't know if that was scripted, was it an audible, or was it just a play call that they had in their pocket? No matter what, they had the right call on against the right defense, and they end up in the end zone.
And tackled at the 21-yard line, so a net negative there of 4 yards. Murray and the Cardinals with a first and 10 at their own 21. A first carry for Kenyon Drake. And that play going absolutely nowhere as he's belted before he could get out of the backfield. A 3-yard loss to start the drive. They'll look to make that up and then some on second and 13. Murray a give. This is Drake. He is taken down at the 21 after a short gain of two. When we talk about defenders, specifically linebackers, keeping their eyes in the right spot, he had that eye down the entire time.
And you know that's not easily done because they throw a lot of misdirection at you. They try and fool you and get your eyes in the wrong place. But you're right about that one. He correctly figured that one out and made a really nice play.
And he will be marked down short of the first as they get to him at the 29.
Brings up fourth down.
Here we go on fourth down with Murray. And this is incomplete. So certainly an interesting call there to go for it. And it'll be a turnover on downs. So they take a big, big chance here in their own territory. And you think the coach may have some questions to answer?
Yeah, and you know, normally we focus on the media, right? The social media barrage that he's going to get for this one. How about on his own sideline and in his locker room? Because I think the team's going to look at him like, coach, well, why would we go for it there? I mean, no confidence in the defense. You don't like the punter. I mean, what's going on here? You owe us some explanations.
Throwing on first down is Locke. The ball popped in the air and intercepted. Buda Baker with a pick. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
This interception will go on the record of the quarterback, but as a receiver, you've got to understand where you are in the field. Middle portion, you know it's going to come in hot. Square your body to the quarterback and be ready to make the catch.
Here's a run on first down that doesn't accomplish anything. In fact, he's going to be tackled behind the line for a loss of one. Plays like we just saw there, that's why they're up right now. And the defense, they're doing their job.
Yeah, it starts with the guys up front. So when you talk with GMs who are putting together a team, a lot of them say, we're going to build from the inside out. Because if you control the line of scrimmage, you control the rest of the ball game. And that's what we're seeing here. They're actually playing in the offense's backfield, not necessarily just playing at the line of scrimmage.
It was Bryce Callahan jarring the ball free defensively. An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down.
Certainly looked like someone was very confident in his ability to fit that one in.
Try to get it to Williams, but it's intercepted. Picked off by Justin Simmons. And he's going to get this on down to the 13-yard line. From the 13 now, they work on first and 10.
Take over first and 10.
After the turnover, here's Locke. He's just going to dump this one off to his fullback out of the backfield. And he wasn't blocking or running it there. They tossed it to him.
And you remember the good old days when the 49ers were riding roughshod in the league? They used their fullback in pass plays all the time. Roger Craig, Tom Rathman, those guys were terrific at running these types of plays.
And it's good, and they have jumped out here to a quick 14-0 first quarter lead.
14.
After the touchdown, here's McManus now to kick it away. Now this will make it into the end zone. And the decision to come out of the end zone is going to cost him 5 yards as he's taken down right at the 20.
At their own 20-yard line.
Ready to go with their next drive and at the line, the Cardinal offense. And they're in an early hole. First drive, they threw the interception. That led to a touchdown. So decent-sized deficit early on.
It is, but I think you hit the key words, early on. So they have to decide, do we even need to change game plan? Or do we just need to execute better and try and get back in this game?
16 yards right off the bat and a first down. A first carry for the Fordham Ram, Chase Edmonds. And he'll take this one for about four up to the 40.
Ball carrier.
Well, on every play call, you realize it's not going to go for a touchdown. So a lot of your calls are setting things up for maybe later in the game, trying to establish the inside run, run with toughness now, hopefully get to the perimeter later. And let's face it, you could do worse than a four-yard run on first down.
Kenyon Drake.
Another catch for him there on this drive, Brandon. And it looks like they're going to utilize him out of the backfield any way they can. And that time, they pick up a first down. So now on defense, you assign a man to him and try and cover him before he gets going.
And he got blown up. Losing yardage on the play back at the 44. 2 yards the loss, second and 12. 14-0 the score. This is the NFL on EA Sports. Side Fitzgerald, and he'll lose yardage here back at the 41. Third and 15 coming up after that loss of two. Murray going to run play action with Drake and look to throw it.
Escaping the pressure right. He's going to run, but he's got a long way to go. And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. The scramble good for a nice gain of 10 yards, but still fourth down. Well, the offense failed earlier on the previous crack at this, but they're going again on fourth down. They're going for it. Hits Murray. Flushed out right. And he's got the completion to Hopkins. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. Not often do fourth down conversions result in 23 yards, but that's the case here. First down. They'll run with Drake. And he stopped immediately there. No gain on the play there. Second down.
Well done to sniff that out defensively. He had it diagnosed pretty quickly.
I love that description because diagnosed is perfect on that one. Read his keys, made the play, and he couldn't even get going moving the football.
They get seven out of that, so they're left with a third and three.
That's a really nice job by them picking up the run blitz and detecting it and blocking it and turning it into a nice run. And a lot of times you think if you blitz a running play, you're going to smother it. But a lot of the blitzers, they come in a little bit high. They don't have great leverage, and they're easily blocked and turned to the side.
And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Arizona.
Arizona.
Scampering home from 19 yards out. And the Cardinals draw a bit closer. A solid blocking up front from the guys on the offensive line allowed him to get in for the touchdown.
Yeah, some might say that the guys on the offensive line were in concert. I used to have a coach who called it marrying up, meaning when you get on a guy, you just stay right there. And each guy has his own assignment that allowed the runner to make the big move towards the end zone.
And taken down just past the 20 at about the 21-yard line.
At their own 21-yard line.
The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. After the long touchdown drive we just saw, you wonder if maybe that's taken a little of the wind out of this offensive sails because they had it going pretty good last time, too.
Had to sit over there for a little while, didn't they? You know, they were eager, amped up to get back on the field after just scoring, hoping to get the ball back quickly. That didn't happen, so I'd say come out, just kind of get started again. You know, it doesn't have to be anything dramatic. Just get moving, get loose again, and see if they can get it downfield.
We've hit the two-minute mark of the second quarter, 14-7. A reminder, coming up at halftime, Jonathan Coachman will join us from Orlando with our halftime report, but business to take care of before we get there.
A two-minute drill before the coaches' two-minute drill.
And they'll take him down at the 31-yard line. On first down, Locke. They'll let this go deep for Sutton. And this is, oh my goodness, he pulled it in one-handed. A huge play there for Denver. 51 yards. A real field flipper there as all of a sudden they've got a first down in the red zone. Dancing to his left. He's going to take off with it. And he'll be out of bounds about a half to a full yard shy of the five. Nothing open downfield. He keeps it himself for 11 and a first down.
First down. First and goal at the 6-yard line.
Now Locke. Screen pass to Lindsey. And he is into the end zone for a Denver touchdown. From 6 yards away. And the Broncos will add on to their lead. Touchdowns on their first three possessions, and they're a PAT from going up 21-7.
Yeah, very impressive the way that they've moved the football. Full command of their playbook, full command of the way they wanted to attack.
Brandon McManus to kick off for Denver.
After the touchdown, here's McManus now to kick it away.
The Cardinals take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
Ready to go with their next drive and at the line, the Cardinal offense. And what do you think goes on here in this situation? If you got the football, you're trailing, you're back in your own territory with just a little time. Do you try something?
You're thinking about jump-starting your team, right? You just mentioned it. They're down. They're trying to get back into the game. But you got to figure, if something goes wrong, you may have put yourself in a spot where you may not be able to come back in the second half. Managing risk, this is a big decision here.
First down, Murray. Flush to his right. Now on the run, he'll throw it back deep over the middle. And it's knocked away and incomplete. The former first-round pick, Kareem Jackson, there defensively.
Early on, the running game's been working well, and the offensive line has been pleased by that. The thought process there, catch those safeties creeping up, trying to help against the running game. They tried to hit him over the top unsuccessfully.
Murray again, second and 10. And a six-yard gain gets him right around the 43.
Complete.
The Cardinals going to use the first of their timeouts as it'll come with 36 ticks to go in half number one. They face a third and four after that last completion gets them six. Out of the gun, here's Murray. Fitzgerald bringing it in over the middle. And he's able to get the first before he's taken down at the 36. Now the Cards going to call another timeout, their second, as they get it right at the 32nd mark of this first half. Murray now on first down. And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down. Well, the incompletion, yes, but maybe here not the worst thing in the world?
No, not on first and 10. It actually gives them a chance to regroup, relax just a little bit. They huddle up, talk it over. Then they get a chance to continue their drive.
Going deep for Hopkins. That's going to be caught. And he'll take this one in for the Arizona touchdown. DeAndre Hopkins, as the first half is winding down, and the Cardinals have cut it to within a score. Gonzalez good on the extra point, and they're back within a touchdown at 21-14. So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away. Fielded a couple yards into the end zone. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24. Denver offense at the line, ready to go. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
Now the Broncos are going to call the first of their timeouts. As they stop it with 11 seconds remaining in this first half. On first down, right back to Lindsey. And they'll get to him after a gain of 7 to the 47. Now a timeout taken. Perhaps a chance for one more quick play and then another timeout if they hurry. We'll see. Throwing on second and 3. Lock. Now whistles and a timeout with 3 seconds left in the first half.
A loss of 9 on the play. Brings up third down.
So third and long now for Locke and the Broncos following the sack. A final shot before half for Locke. They're looking for Judy, but it's intercepted. Picked off by the Alabama man, Dre Kirkpatrick. And he will be brought down as time is now run out on this first half of action.
That's the end.
So two quarters down, two remain. Charles and I return after the break. Okay, coach, appreciate it. A one touchdown game here as we get set to resume play in the second half. It'll be the Cardinals who get the ball first. They trail here as we resume action in the third quarter. Ready to go with their next drive and at the line, the Cardinal offense. And for them, a touchdown their last go around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked. but you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
Give him a couple on the carry there. Second and eight.
Brings up second and eight.
They stay on the ground with Drake. And he's taken down but able to slip across the 35. It's a first down on a gain of 10.
It's a gain of 10. And the Cardinal first down.
Now Drake. And he is met at the line of scrimmage and he goes down right there. Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be second down.
As usual, the hallmark of a good run defense, linebackers making plays near the line of scrimmage. Absolutely nowhere to run there.
That's going to be knocked away and incomplete. It was Bryce Callahan jarring the ball free defensively.
Well, you got to think that sooner or later, they're going to hit one of those, but the coverage has been excellent thus far. And it was again on the last play.
An important play right here, third and 10.
And I would expect pressure here.
And the Broncos get there and take him down. Barreling in for the sack, Shelby Harris. They were trying to set up that screen, trying to get that screen to formulate. Took too long.
He ends up taking a sack, and that leads you to a couple of other questions. Number one, why don't you just get rid of the football near the screen, guy, so that you don't take an interception? But really, the big one, they just took everything away, and he was really kind of flummoxed on that play and ended up taking the sack.
A good kick that time, but also a pretty good 15-yard return. And the Broncos take over, first down and 10. They'll start on the ground with Lindsey. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down, second and right at a yard.
It's brought him down. It's a gain of 9. Brings up
from the 39. Lock.
At the 39.
Got an open man here, and it's KJ Hamler.
They ain't ready for us.
And all the way home for a Broncos score. KJ Hamler, 61 yards. And the Broncos will extend their lead.
Partner, they had a good lead as they went in at the half, and they came out here in the second half and found a way to extend it. I love their consistency. Don't worry about what they said at halftime. This seemed like a team that was ready to play 60 minutes, and while this game is far from over, I love their approach.
The Cardinals take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
Ready to go with their next drive, and at the line, the Cardinal offense. And with this deficit, you can't have too many more drives like the last drive where you had to punt it away.
You know what I would tell my offense right here? The punter doesn't exist, guys.
And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off by Bryce Callahan. A young quarterback, Charles, rolling to his right. I know he's right-handed, but is that one that maybe a veteran sticks in his pocket?
I think so, but you have to remember with young quarterbacks, it may take a few years before they get all the stuff out of them that they did earlier in their career or even in their college days when they were used to being dominant. In this case, the NFL veteran defense ended up winning the battle.
A good pick up there, 26 yards. Now a first and 10 at the 11.
And that's how you throw for a whole heap of yards in a game. You get efforts like that from your receivers. How about him laying out for that catch?
Yeah, excellent. Makes a quarterback look a whole lot better. Officially, it's a one-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11.
Brings up second and 11.
On the slant, completes to Sutton. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Denver score. Cortland Sutton on the touchdown pass from Drew Locke. And the Broncos turn that interception into a touchdown.
Lining up for the extra point.
And he's been a busy man. 5 for 5 now as he knocks another one through to extend the lead.
35. Cardinals 14. Brandon McManus to kick off for Denver.
After the touchdown, here's McManus now to kick it away. On the return, here's Edmonds. And up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25.
At their own 26-yard line.
ready to go with their next drive and at the line, the Cardinal offense. And last time, one play interception. So this offense, they should be fresh.
That's a good way of putting it. And I can't wait to see what they decide to do with play calling, because a one-play drive where you throw an interception, a lot of people think the very next time out, run the football, don't give them a chance.
Maybe play action?
I think maybe you go play action, show your quarterback, get a little confidence in him, and let him fling another one.
Murray looks to throw again, second and 10. And boy, that one drops incomplete, but if he was hit a fraction sooner, it may have been a fumble.
Well, defensively, they haven't let him just sit in the pocket and get comfortable, and that's opposite a lot of game plans in today's NFL. Ordinarily, you're trying to keep the quarterback hemmed in. In this case, they brought the heat, and if he flushes out, they're fine with that, and they force another incompletion.
Now the third down throw incomplete as well.
As defensive coordinators around the league tell me all the time, that throw is not for every quarterback, because you really got to drive the ball downfield. It's going to be a tight window.
And look at this, it's a fake. And he's not going to get to the marker. And that's a turnover on downs. A little trickeration there, but it doesn't fool him. And the Broncos are going to get the football back in great field position. Steps away to his left. He's going to take off with it. He'll get five out of the scramble. It's second down.
Now, how about that play? He took a possible negative and turned it into positive yardage and slid down to avoid taking a big shot. Excellent job getting down and avoiding the big hit.
He's going to take a shot for the end zone. And that is caught. Touchdown, Denver. Alberto there to make the grab. And the Broncos push further out in front.